Hello, welcome again. We are solving basic thermodynamics. The topic is entropy. Question number 8 is, air flows through an adiabatic compressor at 2 kg per second. The inlet conditions are 1 bar and 310 Kelvin. The exit conditions are 7 bar and 560 Kelvin. There are three questions based on this. First is work required for compression. Second is availability transfer. And third is irreversibility added during the compression process. So compressor inlet temperature is T1 is 310 Kelvin. And compressor exit temperature T2 is 560 Kelvin. Mass is 2 kg. Okay, so the work required is MCP T2 minus T1. So CP is given as it is here, so CP is 1.005. Okay. So 2 into 1.005, 560 minus 300, so that is 502.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. So that is the particular, that is the answer to the first question. Second question is availability transfer, third question is irreversibility. So to find out both of these, we have to find out the entropy generation during this process. So the entropy generation during this process can be find out using the dq by dt is equal to dq by dt plus dw by dt plus dw by t, sorry, dq by t is equal to dw by t plus dw by t using first law and then divided by temperature. So dq by t is equal to mcv dt by t plus pdv by t, or this integrating with we have s2 minus s1. MCV ln T2 by T1 plus MR ln V2 by V1. Okay. Now we have initial temperature and pressure and final temperature and final pressure. Okay. So we can put these values. So initial temperature and pressure are, initial conditions are 1 bar and 310 and so final are 7 bar and 560. So this is your 560 by 310 and this is your 1 by 7, 560 by 310. So putting this value, we have m is equal, we can get entropy generation as 0.0719 kilojoule per degree Kelvin. Okay. So this is your entropy added. So now first we find out the irreversibility, then we find out availability transfer. So according to Gauss-Stuglitz theorem, we have entropy irreversibility T0 is equal to T0 multiplied by entropy generation. So T0 is 298 and entropy generation is this, that is 21.2 kilowatt. Okay, and availability change is S2 minus S1 minus T0 S2 minus S1. So S2 minus S1, we have found out that is 502.5. Okay. And this we also found out. Okay, so availability transfer will be 481.1 kilowatt. So answer is 481.1 kilowatt.